Hey guys, so in today's video, I'm sharing with you how I photograph a reception and all the details that go into that. But last week I shared how I photographed the bride getting ready. I did some ceremony setup. We did bride and groom at sunset and a complete view of where I stand and how I photograph the ceremony itself. So if you haven't seen that, definitely go back and take a look. So today, here I am. I am in the reception room. So this was where about 120 or so guests were going to be enjoying their dinner. And this was right before they were allowed to come into the room. So I wanted to make sure that I got all of those details that were inside the room. So the table decor, the florals, the name cards, all that kind of stuff. I make sure that I get both horizontal and verticals of everything in the space, and I do my best to get this without people in it, but you know, I just don't always have control over that, and so I do my best. Sometimes I gotta Photoshop some people out. So here I am using off-camera flash. My assistant, who is filming this right now from the perspective that you're seeing, she's holding my flash for me because there was no room for the stand. So if I didn't have my assistant, I just would have put the flash on one of the tables and let it do its thing. So as you can see, this is kind of the other perspective from the other side of the room. So I continue to work my way throughout the room, making sure that I covered all of those gorgeous details. I know they had cotton and magnolias and all kinds of gorgeous flowers on these tables. And I just wanted to make sure that I fully covered that before guests were able to come in. So as you can see, actually across the room where I'm standing right now, if you keep looking through there, that's where the reception is going to take place, where the majority of the dancing is going to happen and the majority of the toasts and the cake cutting and all of the events. So that's really where I'm setting up my off-camera flash, but I wasn't able to bring that flash all the way in here because it was just too awkward and tight with all these tables. So that's why I have my assistant holding the flash separately behind the scenes. This is the perspective from the other side of the room. So this is where all the dancing is going to take place. And here you can see we're kind of setting up, people are mingling in, and I decided that I needed to stop and talk to the videographer, make sure that we were on the same page and we were setting up our lights, making sure that where the bride and groom were going to be entering in and where we were standing were going to work out really well. So we were just arranging that here, and then we both decided that we were going to try to stick to the same side so that we don't get in each other's shot. So we're all kind of hanging out here towards the back of this dance floor where our couples are going to come in. They came in. You can see here that I have my off-camera flash set up and an on-camera flash set up. So even right here in this next shot, you can actually see my flash is just off to the upper right-hand corner here. And that flash is going to be at 1/16th power right around there for pretty much the rest of the night. It just adds a little bit of fill, really lightens up her dress and all those details. And then of course the flash that I have on camera is going to fill them as well. What's happening here is I'm probably going to have to use a little bit more flash power and a little bit higher ISO than I normally do, because if you look up, you can see that the ceiling is vaulted, but it's also pretty dark. It has a wood tone, so it's going to really absorb that light and it's going to bounce back as a color cast and kind of give you some yellow tones. So that's why we're trying to use off-camera flash so that we can bring that beautiful clean light directly to my couples, fill in their faces, get all those details, and not have the color cast come from the ceiling. So I don't want my only flash to be on camera, otherwise it's gonna be pretty yellow and it's gonna be a little bit hard to balance for those skin tones. So as you can see here, we are now doing open dancing. We've already covered their first dance. I'm just bebopping around here on the dance floor and my flash settings are pretty much the same. I'm finding different moments and I'm really focusing on the bride and groom, but when they're off the dance floor, I'm making sure that I get lots of their family members, grandparents, anybody who's having a good time. And this is also when I'm taking time to take portraits of anybody whose families want portraits or that kind of thing. So we just call those grabbing grins, where they get together, take a quick pic, move on. And I love to do those because I think those are so fun for the couple to get inside of their gallery when they didn't expect that and they had no idea that we took them. So just some little bonus portraits there for them as well. I love when the couple puts the cake in the middle of the dance floor because we can get some nice separation with the off-camera flash, and we can also get some different angles by moving around them versus them being in a corner or against a wall. It's a little harder for my second shooter and I to get really different angles when it's not in the middle of the dance floor. So this was a nice treat. Here, of course, I'm sticking around. I'm making sure that I keep taking pictures, keep firing, keep getting those moments, the kisses, them feeding each other the cake until they're completely done and they're walking away, because you never know in these moments when they might do a quick dip or they may do an impromptu toast or start dancing. And this is just a perfect photo opportunity. So don't stop shooting even once they're done cutting the cake, because these photos are just gold. The rest of the night is going to be open dancing from here on out. They've already done their toasts and special dances, but this is just a great time to really get out on the dance floor, use a nice wide angle lens, and make sure that you're getting those big shots of everybody on the dance floor having a good time. And this is a really great time to also play around with your flash and get a little bit more of a dramatic look and feel to your images. If you enjoyed watching this video and you want to see more like it, definitely hit subscribe. I make videos every single week here on my YouTube channel, and I would love to have you stick around. It's also to my amazing team who filmed this and helped me through this entire wedding day. Couldn't have done it without you guys. If you liked videos like this one today, you're going to love this one on your screen right now. This one is going to show you all of how I shoot a ceremony, but also so much more. So be sure to check it out, and I'll see you over there.